sem.
Hallelujah. Let's raise our hands.
Dvignimo roke. Let's,
thank you, Lord.
Hvala ti, Gospod.
Thank you, Lord, for the freedom you're bringing.
Hvala za svobodo, ki jo
prinašaš. Thank you, Lord, that no longer will we live under perfectionism and performance.
Da ne bomo več živeli pod perfekcijo in performanceom.
But we're free, Lord, to walk into the spirit realm.
Da smo svobodni, da hodimo v duhovnem svetu.
And to pursue a spirit of excellence.
In da sledujemo duha odličnosti.
Thank you for healing from our past, Lord.
Hvala za ozdravljenje od naše preteklosti.
Thank you, Lord, for the deliverance that you're bringing to us, Lord.
Za ozdravljenje, ki nam ga prinašaš.
Thank you, Lord, for fresh move of the Holy Spirit.
Za svež gibanje.
Thank you for oil.
Za olje.
Fresh wind, fresh wine.
Viter.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Hvala ti, Gospod.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. We receive everything that you have for us
Sveti
today,
Duh,
Lord.
Mi sprejmamo vse od tebe, you, kar imaš za nas.
We open our heart, no walls,
odpiramo
no
srce,
barriers.
Ni preprek, ni zidov.
We want to hear what you have to say, Lord.
Mi želimo slišati, kar želiš povedati, Gospod.
Hallelujah, we're listening.
Mi poslušamo.
We're listening, Lord. Hallelujah.
Gospod.
Thank you, Lord.
Hvala ti, Gospod.
Hallelujah. It's a great day, church. It's
Dobar
a great
dan,
day to be alive.
Dobar dan, da smo lahko
God
živi.
Says, in the last days I'll pour out my spirit
Gospod
on all flesh.
V poslednjih časih bom izlil svojega duha na vse meso.
Your sons and your daughters.
Vaši sinovi in
hčere. Hallelujah. That there'll be visions, prophecies,
bodo prerokovali,
dreams,
sanjali sanje,
revelation of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
God's doing that.
To dela Gospod.
He's doing that in our nation.
On dela tudi v našem
Hallelujah. Narodu. It's a day, great day of salvation.
To je velik
Hallelujah.
Dan
The Lord is drawing people to himself.
Gospod kliče ljudi in jih približuje k sebi.
A great day of freedom.
Dobar dan svobode.
Hallelujah. God is breaking bondages.
Bog lomi okove.
And he whom the sun sets free is free indeed.
Kogarkoli sin osvobodi, je svoboden.
No longer to walk into bondage.
Nič več ne hodi v okovih.
Can you say I'm free?
Ali lahko rečete, jaz sem svoboden. Jaz sem svoboden.
I'm free.
Jaz sem svoboden.
I'm free.
Jaz sem svoboden.
Oh, hallelujah, I'm free. Hallelujah. This session we're going to talk about anger and bitterness.
V tem delu pa bomo govorili o jezi in zagrenjenosti.
And in the world, anger is rising.
V svetu se jeza dviga.
The level of anger is rising.
Raven jeze se dviga.
I was just watching the news and they were talking about that.
Ravno sem gledala novice, ki so govorili o tem.
How quickly people just lose their temper.
Kako hitro v teh časih ljudje izgubijo svoj temperament.
I was talking to a couple that were here from Brighton, England.
Zadnjič sem se pogovarjala s parom iz Brightona.
And he's half Slovene, half English.
On je pol Slovenec, pol Angliš.
And he said, I learned to drive in Slovenia.
In je rekel, jaz sem se naučil voziti tudi v Sloveniji.
But it's easier to drive around London and Brighton than it is in Slovenia.
A je lažje se voziti v Brightonu, v Londonu.
Because so many people are on your tail. So many people are on your tail.
Yeah. V Sloveniji je veliko ljudi na tvojem repu, ko vozijo.
I'll give you my answer what I do with crazy drivers.
Vam bom pol delila z vami odgovor, kaj jaz naredim z norimi vozniki.
I always think, what if that was someone I love driving that car?
Vedno pomislim, kaj če je to nekdo, ki ga ljubim, ki vozi ta
auto. Second thing I think about is, you know, they're probably having a really bad day.
Drugo, kar pomislim, je, da imajo verjetno zelo slab dan.
And then I'll start to pray for them. Lord, give them peace.
In potem
oh,
moliti,
Jesus,
Gospod,
come
mir.
Into that vehicle.
Jezus, vstopi v ta auto.
Give them peace.
Daj mir.
Whatever they're struggling with.
S čimerkoli se borijo.
Hallelujah. I was listening to a testimony.
Poslušala sem pričevanje.
And a man, he had had a scary experience as a child.
Bog je imel, moški je imel strašno izkušnjo v otroštvu.
They lived out by a lake.
Živeli so ob jezeru.
And some men had pulled in with a truck.
In prišli so neki možje z tovornjakom.
And they were drunk.
Bili so pijani.
And they tried to capture him and his friend that were playing basketball.
Hoteli so ujeti njega in njegovega prijatelja medtem, ko sta igrala košarko.
And they took off running.
In sta zbežala od njih.
They were not caught. Praise
God. Hvala Bogu, jih nista bila ujeta.
But inside he had never dealt with the fear.
A v sebi se ni nikoli soočil s tem strahom.
Of this trauma.
Te traume.
And it built and built.
In to se je povečevalo znotraj.
So now he's married and has a few kids.
Zdaj pa je poročen in ima že nekaj otrok.
And they're driving down the road and someone's behind him.
In ko se vozijo po cesti in je nekdo za njimi.
They put their horn on.
Če trobijo.
When they're passing, they roll down the window, they're cussing at him.
In če ga preklinjajo in izpuščajo dol okno, ko grejo mimo njega.
And just like that, he was ready to go after them.
Se tako užge in je pripravljen, da gre za njim.
He wanted to kill them, literally.
Dejansko si jih želil.
The rage was so deep.
Tako močna je jeza v njem.
And he stopped because he wanted his wife and children to get out of the car.
Ustavil se, ker je želel, da med tem izstopijo otroci in žena.
And she said, I'm not getting out of this car.
Ampak žena je rekla, ne grem iz tega avta, ne boš šel za njimi.
And it was long enough that he defused.
To je vsaj toliko časa trajalo, da se je mečkem pomiril.
But this kind of quick to anger.
Ampak to vrstno hitra jeza, ne?
Destroys relationships.
Uniči odnose.
It destroys families.
Uniči družine.
Marriages.
Zakone.
And causes people to be in a place that they never dreamed they would be.
In povzroči, da se ljudje znajdejo v stanju, v katerem si niso predstavljali, da bodo kadarkoli.
Well, that man, he repented. He got help.
Ta moški se je spokoril.
He got free from anger.
Pomoč, bil osvobojen od jeze.
And he's never been triggered like that again.
In nikoli več se ni tako sprožil.
But I'm going to read some scriptures from Proverbs, but before that I want to talk about three people in the Bible that had an episode of anger.
Preden delim z vami nekaj iz Svetega pisma, bi rada govorila o treh ljudeh v Bibliji, ki so imeli težave z jezo.
And what the result was.
In kaj je bila posledica tega?
The first one was Cain.
Prvi je bil Kain.
Cain gave an offering to God from his crops and Abel had given a lamb.
Kain je dal svoje daritev Bogu iz svoje žetve, Abel pa je dal od svojih ovc.
And the lamb was a symbol of Jesus and how his blood would actually cleanse the world.
Jagnje je bil simbol Jezusa, predno je prišel. Kaj bo on dejansko naredil na zemlji?
And Cain's offering was a symbol of man's work. I'll do it my way, God. I want to impress you with what I can do.
Kainova daritev pa je bila simbol tega lastnoročnega človeškega truda. Kako želimo impresionirati Boga, kaj bomo mi naredili?
Well, God couldn't accept Cain's offering.
Bog ni mogel sprejeti Kainove daritve.
But God talked to him in the garden.
Bog se je pogovoril s Kainom v vrtu.
And he said, Cain, sin would try to grab hold and conquer you.
Rekel mu je, Kain, greh se te bo hotel polastiti.
And yet, even though God talked to him, God warned him.
Bog pogovoril z njim in ga je opozoril.
He went out and murdered his brother.
Je vseeno šel in umoril svojega brata.
The first murder.
To je bil prvi umor.
God's grace is so great. He would talk to him in the middle of his rage.
Božja milost pa je tako velika, da se dejansko govoril z njim sredi njegovega besa.
And when anger comes, the Holy Spirit will come to you.
Ko bo prišla jeza, bo prišel tudi
Sveti
Duh. And
you will have the word of the Lord say, stop.
In boste slišali Božjo besedo, ustavi se.
Don't go further.
Nadaljuj s tem.
The only way that doesn't happen is if you've lived such an angry life, you've opened yourself and a demon of anger has entered.
Edini način, da se to ne zgodi, je, če ste živeli tako življenje polno jeze, da je vstopil demon jeze v vas.
And a person who is in that place is no longer in control.
Človek, ki pa je obseden s takim demonom, pa ni več v kontroli.
The second person I want to look at is Moses.
Druga osebo, ki jo želim omeniti, je Mojzes.
Moses is amazing, huh?
Mojzes je res čudovit.
He loved the presence of God.
On je ljubil Božjo prisotnost.
His face would shine from the glory of God.
Njegov obraz je žarel od slave Gospodove.
He saw the most amazing miracles.
Videl je najbolj neverjetne čudeže.
And he even wrote about himself, I am the meekest man on the earth.
O sebi je celo pisal, da je najbolj kreposten človek.
That's real humility. He wasn't even proud of it. Okay, so what happened with Moses?
Kaj se je zgodilo z Mojzesom?
He had a lot of trials with the children of Israel.
Imel je veliko preizkušenj z otroci Izraelovimi.
They could never remember the miracles that God did.
Ker Izraelci se nikoli niso mogli zapomniti čudeže, ki jih je Bog naredil za njih.
Every time there was a crisis, they're complaining.
Kadarkoli je bila kriza, so se spet pritoževali.
Why did you bring us from Egypt?
Zakaj si nas pripeljal iz Egipta?
We don't have onions, we don't have leeks.
Mi nimamo.
Čebula.
Mi nimamo poor. Česen.
I mean, I don't know if those are your favorite foods, but...
Ne vem, če so to vaše najljubše jedi.
But they're always complaining.
Vedno so se pritoževali.
And so, the first time they're without water...
Prvič, ko so bili brez vode.
He's like, you know, God, you've done so many miracles, what do I do?
In rekel Mojzes, Bog, naredil si že toliko čudežev, kaj ne naredim?
The Lord says, strike the rock, Moses.
Bog je rekel, udari skalo, Mojzes.
Strikes the rock.
Mojzes, udari skalo.
Water.
In ven priteče voda.
Water comes out. This is so cool. I mean, I'm thinking like 500,000 people are thirsty.
Jaz razmišljam, pol milijona ljudi je žejnih.
This is not just a little water.
To ni samo malo vode.
This is a massive amount of water that God brought out of a rock.
To je bilo res veliko vode, ki je prišla ven iz skale.
So, a few years later they're going around the mountain again.
Nekaj let kasneje hodijo okoli gore ponovno.
And there's no water again.
In spet ni več vode.
And Moses was so tired.
In Mojzes je bil tako utrujen.
Frustrated.
V frustraciji.
I said, "Don't you remember? Don't you remember when God brought water out of the rock?"
A se ne spomnite, kako je Bog pripeljal vodo iz skale?
He says, "Okay, Lord, what do we do?" And God says, "Speak to the rock."
In vprašal Boga, kaj naredim? In Bog je rekel, spregovori skali.
And he's so mad.
In je bil tako jezen.
I don't want to speak. He takes his staff.
Rekel je, jaz ne želim govoriti skali.
And he strikes the rock.
In udaril skalo.
Uh-oh. Water comes.
Voda pride.
But God says,
a Bog pravi,
Moses,
Moises,
you didn't obey me.
Nisi me obogal.
You don't get to go in the promised land.
Ne boš šel v obljubljeno deželo.
Oh, church.
Cerkev.
What can anger stop?
Vidite, kaj lahko
how damaging it can be that God judged Moses this strongly.
Da je Jezus tako močno obsodil Mojzesa.
And I can imagine Moses saying, but God, you said that you wanted to destroy these people before. Lord, it's their fault. It's their fault that I'm angry.
Gospod, pa si rekel, da želiš soditi, pa njihova krivda je, da sem tako jezen.
Mothers, have you ever thought that thought?
Matere,
it's their fault that I'm angry, Lord. You know how they're acting. No, God does not take that and say, you have a free anger, get angry card. No.
Bog ne dojema tega tako, da imate potem prosto pot, da ste jezni. To so nevarna področja.
The last one I want to look at is the strangest story about anger that I think is in the Bible.
Tretja zgodba pa je ena bolj čudnih v Svetem pismu.
And it's Jonah.
In to je Jona.
Okay. Jonah first didn't want to follow God's will.
Najprej ni želel zasledovati Božje volje.
He didn't like the call.
Ni mu bil všeč klic.
God told him to go to people he didn't like.
Bog mu je rekel, naj gre k ljudem, ki jih ni maral.
And he wanted them to be destroyed by judgment.
In hotel je, he wanted fire. On je si je želel, da so
they're wicked, Lord. They deserve it.
Rekel je, oni so zlobni, oni so to zaslužijo.
Well, you all know the story how God did a lot of miracles to get Jonah to Nineveh.
Vsi poznate to zgodbo, kako je Bog kako je Bog pripeljal Jona do Nineve.
He was the first fish transport.
On je bil prvi, ki je doživel ribji transport.
Before Pinocchio. Never mind. Okay. So, he preaches and they all fast and pray.
On jim pridiga in vsi molijo.
They repent.
Oh,
he doesn't like that. So he's sitting on a hill above the city looking down.
Jona sedi na hribu in gleda navzdol.
Waiting for the fire.
Čaka na ogenj.
Oh, come on, God.
Daj Bog.
Strike them.
Udari.
I preached if they don't repent, they're gonna burn. Where are you, God? Why aren't they burning?
Okay.
So nothing happens, and then God allows this beautiful plant to grow.
Nič se ne zgodi. Še celo več. Bog dovoli, da zraste lepa velika rastlina.
In one day this plant is like a huge palm and it gives him shade.
V enem dnevu je kot palma in mu daje senco.
Oh, and he loves it. He sits down and I love this.
In reče, všeč mi je to.
And the next day,
in naslednji dan,
God provides a worm. A worm.
Bog priskrbi črva.
And it eats
in naje to palmo, to
and the plant it dies.
In rastlina umre.
It's gone. And he's so angry.
In Jonas je spet,
he says, Lord, I'm so angry I could die.
Spet jezen reče, Bog, tako sem jezen, da bi lahko umrl.
Oh, now this is when we really are having a problem with our will against God's will. I'm so angry I could die.
To je tisto, ko imamo težavo z Božjo voljo. Ni taka, kot je naša.
And God says you cared more about this plant than 150,000 people who didn't know their right hand from their left.
Gospod mu očita, bolj draga ti je ta rastlina in kaj se bo z njo zgodilo, kot kaj se zgodi 150,000 prebivalci, ki niso vedeli, kaj je prav in kaj je narobe.
See, anger can come in different ways, in different circumstances.
Jeza lahko pride na različne načine in v različnih okoliščinah.
But it's almost always damaging.
A vedno škoduje, skoraj vedno škoduje.
There is a holy anger.
Obstaja tudi sveta jeza.
Jesus had a holy anger in the temple.
Jezus je imel sveto jezo v templju.
When he said, my house shall be called a house of prayer for all nations.
Ko je rekel, moj dom, moja hiša se bo imenovala hiša molitve za vse narode.
You're ruining it.
In vi to uničujete.
You're absolutely ruining it.
Vi to popolnoma uničujete.
You've made it a den of thieves.
Napravili ste ga v brlog tatov.
You've made it about everything that the Father did not want it to be about.
Naredili ste jo za vse, kar Bog ni želel, da je.
The type of anger today that would be a holy anger is anger against human trafficking.
V današnjih časih bi bil primer svete jeze, recimo jeza na trgovalce z belim blagom.
Or anger against abuse.
Ali jeza proti zlorabam.
Saying, God, I want to make a difference. Lord, I'm available.
In ko rečemo, Gospod, tukaj smo na voljo.
I want to make a difference.
Želimo narediti spremembo.
But most anger comes out of our heart because we don't get our way.
A večina jeze pride iz našega srca, ker ni po naše.
Our will is blocked.
Naša volja je bila blokirana.
And we feel like we don't have control.
In imamo občutek, da nimamo nadzora.
Psalms 37:8 says, refrain from anger, forsake wrath, fret not yourself, it only leads to evil.
Psalm 37:8, popusti v jezi, zapusti srditost, ne huduj se, to bi se slabo končalo.
Psalms 86:15 says, but you, O God, are merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness.
Psalm 86:15 pa pravi, a ti, Gospod, si usmiljen in milostljiv Bog, počasen v jezi in bogat v dobroti in zvestobi.
Proverbs 14:29 says, whoever is slow to anger has great understanding, but he who has a hasty temper exalts folly.
Pregovori 14:29. Kdor je počasen za jezo, kaže veliko razsodnost. Kdor je nagle jeze, povzdiguje bedaštvo.
God wants us to reflect the heart of the Father.
Bog želi, da smo odsev srca Boga.
To carry the presence of Jesus.
Da nosimo Jezusovo prisotnost.
And he is slow to anger.
In Jezus je počasen v jezi.
And when we are slow to anger, God says you have great understanding.
kadar smo mi počasni v jezi, Bog pravi, da imamo dobro razumevanje.
You're showing Jesus.
Da kažemo Jezusa.
Hallelujah. Stop.
Ustavite se.
When something happens and you just want to get angry.
Ko se nekaj zgodi in se hočete razjeziti.
Stop.
Se ustavite.
Don't say a word.
Nič ne recite.
Because that's the very moment your tongue will want to lead you into wickedness.
Ker ravno to je trenutek, ko vas bo vaš jezik želel zapeljati v zlobo.
When we were first married, Clement and I had always had a long distance relationship.
Na začetku najinega zakona sva imela s Klemenom odnosno na daljavo.
And we had some areas to come to understanding each other.
Bilo je nekaj področij, v katerih sva se mogla še sporazumeti.
And it could be so frustrating to him.
In to je lahko prineslo dosti frustracije.
And so if he got really upset, he would go take a walk.
In kadar se je zelo
stop the talk.
Je ustavil pogovor in šel samo
na sprehod. Let's just go cool off.
Da se ohladil.
And it's wisdom. It's a lot better than stepping past the line, going into anger.
Dosti bolje, ko da prestopiš mejo in se prepustiš jezi.
This is a verse that we taught our boys when they were little.
To pa je vers, ki sva ga naučila najina otroka, ki sta bila še majhna.
Proverbs 15:1.
Pregovori 15:1.
A soft answer turns away wrath, but harsh words stir up anger.
Mil odgovor pomirja togoto, žaljiva beseda pa zbuja jezo.
So, you know our boys, Samuel and David.
Poznate najina sinova, Samuela in Davida.
Their personalities are very different.
Imata zelo različni osebnosti.
David's very black and white.
David je zelo črno-bel.
Sammy knew how to push his little buttons like
Samuel
kids do.
Pritisniti na prave gumbe. Yeah.
So we would say this verse. A gentle answer.
Sva dostikrat ponavljala.
A soft answer.
Mil
turns away wrath.
Govor pomirja jezo.
Harsh words stir up anger.
Žaljiva beseda pa jo zbuja.
Proverbs 15:18 says a hot-tempered man stirs up strife. But he who is slow to anger quiets contention.
Pregovori 15:18 pravi: Jezljiv človek izzove prepir, potrpežljivi pa pomiri spor.
Once again, slow to anger.
Še enkrat, počasi biti v jezi.
There's the funniest little video on these short clips of a little boy, and he's about, I don't know, two, three, maybe. And he's talking to his parents, and he says, it's up here, the mood is up here, let's take it down, can we take it down a little? Let's quiet our voice, let's take it down a little.
In ta dvilitni fantek prigovarja svojim staršom. On pravi, naše počutje je zdaj tukaj, napeto je. Dajmo to malo pomiriti, dajmo to malo znižati.
Yeah, just take it down a little.
Dajmo malo tišati naše glasove.
It's so cute, it ministers to me.
Res je srčno.
Let's take it down a little. Okay. This is a great one. Proverbs
29:11
says, fools give full vent to their rage. But the wise brings calm in the end.
Norec pokaže vso svojo jezo, modri pa jo zadržuje in krti.
Okay. God has called us to be peacemakers.
Bog nas je poklical, da smo mirovniki.
And that doesn't mean that we're bad communicators.
To ne pomeni, da smo slabi komunikatorji.
But we're not controllers.
A nismo tisti, te, ki kontrolirajo.
Sometimes in a home people use anger to control the whole family.
Včasih v domovih ljudje uporabljajo jezo, da nadzorujejo ostale.
And there's two ways that they can do it.
In to lahko naredijo na dva načina.
One is raging and loud.
Eno je z glasnostjo in besom.
And everyone gets quiet and is afraid to do anything.
Takrat vsi utihnejo in se bojijo karkoli narediti.
And the other one is using silence like a weapon.
Drugi način je pa, da uporabljajo tišino kot orožje.
My sister's mother-in-law would quit talking for 2 to 3 weeks when she was having a fight with her husband.
Sestri Nataša je včasih po dva do tri tedne ni govorila s svojim možem.
Some of you men are saying, oh, that sounds like heaven.
Nekateri tukaj pravijo, oh, to je pa slišati kot klem.
Joking, just joking.
Samo hit.
No, but this is another way of using anger to manipulate.
To je drug način, kako lahko zlorabimo jezo za manipulacijo.
So Ephesians 4:31 says, let all bitterness, wrath, and anger, and clamor, and slander be put away from you, along with malice.
V Efežanih 4:31 Bog pravi, naj izginejo med vami vsakršna ujedljivost, vsakršno besnenje, jeza, rohnjenje in priklinjenje z vsakršno hudobijo vred.
Yeah, bitterness is when anger takes hold, and you can't think anything good about that person.
Zagrenjenost, grenkoba je tisto, ko te jeza tako popade, da ne moreš več misliti nič dobrega v tej osebi.
And the Lord says, where there is bitterness, every evil exists.
Gospod pravi, kjer je grenkoba, zagrenjenost, tam obstaja vso zlo.
A root of bitterness spoils the whole tree.
Korenina grenkobe, zagrenjenosti pokvari celotno drevo.
Jesus is saying, let me uproot that.
Jezus pravi, naj izkoreninim to.
Let me bring my blood.
Naj prinesem svojo kri.
Let me wash your thoughts.
Naj operem tvoje misli.
Let me go back to the hurt that caused that bitterness.
Naj grem do te bolečine, ki je povzročila to zagrenjenost.
And I want to show you I was there.
In da ti pokažem, da sem bil tam.
My love was there.
Moja ljubezen je bila
tam.
My
care was there.
Moja skrb je bila tam.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Ephesians 6:4. Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord.
Efežanom 6:4. Očetje, ne provocirajte svojih otrok k jezi. Vzgojite v disciplini, da bodo upoštevali Gospoda.
Yeah. Parents, I want to just encourage you. Set limits for your children.
Starši, želim vas opogumiti. Dajte postaviti meje svojim otrokom.
Don't embarrass them in public.
Ne jih osramotiti v javnosti.
And don't wait until you're so upset that you need to yell loudly.
Ne čaka, da ste tako razburjeni, da morate kričati na glas.
Stop them before it gets that bad.
Ustavite jih, predno pride, postane tako slabo.
Because children, that's a scar to them.
Ker za otroke je to rana.
This is a strange situation. My nephew was the most outgoing little joker in the world. So cute.
Moj nečak je prikupen deček, ki bil zelo šaljiv.
He liked to tell jokes.
Je bil zelo družaben.
And he was very outgoing.
Zelo rad se je družil.
And he was at a family picnic.
In ko je bil enkrat na družinskem pikniku.
And he threw a ball wrong and I think it landed in some food.
Je vrgel žogo in mislim, da je priletela ta žoga na hrano.
And everybody went, oh!
And vsi so vzhičili.
He went and hid.
On se je skril.
And his personality literally changed. From that moment on, I never saw him as free as he was before that moment of deep embarrassment.
Po tistem trenutku velike sramote, ki jo je občutil, se je zavedno spremenil. Nikoli več ga nisem videla tako svobodnega.
Now I know that's not about anger.
Pa vem, da to ne govori glih o jezi.
Anybody would probably react like that.
Verjetno bi vsak od nas tako odreagiral.
But that is just to say how tender the little hearts are that we're raising.
Hotla sem sam prikazati, kako nežna so srca teh, ki jih vzgajamo.
And how the Lord wants us to protect them and bring them up in the Lord.
Kako želi Gospod, da jih varujemo, da jih vzgajamo v njem.
That all of their gifts will be shown.
Da bodo vidni vsi njihovi darovi.
And that they'll be able to do well in life.
In da bodo lahko uspešni v življenju.
Oh, Jesus, give us wisdom.
Jezus, wisdom.
Okay, Colossians 3:8.
Kološanom 3:8.
But now you must put away anger, wrath, malice, slander, and obscene talk from your mouth.
Zdaj pa tudi vi odvrzite vse to jezov, skipljivost, hudobnost, oblikovanje, nesramno govorenje svojih ust.
1 Timothy 2:8, I desire in every place that men should pray, lifting holy hands without anger or quarreling.
1 Timotej 2:8, vsekakor hočem, naj možje posod molijo in zdigujejo svete roke, brez jeze in razpravljanja.
Hallelujah, this is the Lord's desire, women too, that we can lift up holy hands.
To je Božja želja, da lahko dvignemo svete roke.
With no anger,
brez jeze.
With a clean heart,
s čistim srcem.
With a pure heart, hallelujah. I love James 1:19.
Rada imam vers Jakob 1:19.
Know this, my beloved brothers, let every person be quick to hear, slow to speak, slow to anger.
Zavedajte se, moji ljubi bratje, da mora biti vsak človek hiter za poslušanje, počasen za govorenje, počasen za jezo.
This is a key of wisdom.
To je ključ do modrosti.
Quick to hear.
Hiter za poslušanje.
Slow to speak.
Počasen za govorenje.
Slow to anger.
Počasen za jezo.
Lord, help us.
Gospod, pomagaj nam.
Let's just ask him, Holy Spirit,
prosim,
help us.
Sveti Duh, pomagaj nam.
Lord, help me to be quick to hear.
Pomagaj mi, Gospod, da bi lahko hitro poslušal.
Not quick to judge.
Da ne bi hitro sodil.
Quick to hear what's going on with the other person.
Da bi hitro poslušal, kaj je s to z drugo osebo.
Lord, make me slow to speak.
Naredi me, da bom počasen v govorenju.
And slow to anger.
In počasen v jezi.
Hatred stirs up strife, but love covers every offense. Proverbs 10:12.
Sovraštvo zbuja prepire, ljubezen pa pokriva vse napake. Pregovori 10:12.
Hallelujah. Everyone can have a struggle with anger from time to time.
Vsakdo se kdaj lahko bori z jezo.
Do we put it under the blood?
Ali to damo pod kri?
Do we allow the Holy Spirit to keep us moving higher in the Lord?
Ali takrat dovolimo, da nas Sveti Duh dviguje?
Do we seek the fruit of the Spirit?
Ali iščemo takrat sad duha?
Which is peace,
ki je mir,
patience,
potrpežljivost,
self-control.
Samonadzor.
Do we practice forgiveness?
Ali takrat vadimo odpuščanje?
Because if we don't forgive others, the anger will build up.
Ker če ne odpustimo drugim, se bo jeza nabrala.
And then it will explode.
In bo eksplodirala.
We have a state park, a national park that's called Yellowstone.
Mi imamo v ZDA en naravni park, ki se imenuje Yellowstone Park.
And it has one geyser called Old Faithful.
Ki ima gejzir, ki se kliče Stari zvesti.
And on the hour, every hour, boom, it explodes.
In točno na vsako uro ta gejzir eksplodira.
God, he put the fruit of the Spirit in us. He put the Holy Spirit.
Gospod je položil na Svetega Duha, sadove Duha.
So for us to overcome anger,
in da lahko premagamo jezo,
we need to cultivate humility.
Moramo kultivirati ponižnost.
Darko was talking about this.
O tem je govoril Darko prej.
Pride is the only thing that God is so opposed to. He says he'll fight you if you're proud.
Ponos je edina stvar, proti kateri se bo kriz bori. On pravi, da se ti bo upiral, če boš ponosen.
But God gives grace to the humble.
A milost daje ponižnim.
Hallelujah. Grace.
Milost.
Hallelujah. So if you struggle with anger,
torej, če se boriš z jezo,
we need grace.
Rabiš več milosti.
And so we come in humility and say, Lord,
to je vrsta ponižnosti, ko rečeš, Gospod,
I confess.
Jaz priznam.
I've allowed anger in my life.
Dovolil sem jezi, da je vstopila v moje življenje.
And I've used anger to try to control people.
In uporabil sem jezo za nadzor.
Forgive me.
Oprosti me.
Forgive me.
Odpusti mi.
Wash me.
Operi me.
I renounce that.
Odpovedujem se temu.
Hallelujah. So we have to rely on the Holy Spirit. His power is enough to conquer anger.
Zanašati se moramo na Svetega Duha. Njegova moč zadostuje, da lahko se borimo proti jezi.
when Jesus suffered on the cross.
Ko je Jezus trpel na križu.
When he said, "It is finished."
Ko je rekel, končano je.
His work was finished.
Je bilo njegovo delo zaključeno.
And part of that work was he carried anger on himself.
In del tega dela je bilo, da je nosil tudi jezo.
We receive by faith.
Mi prejmemo po veri.
Deliverance and healing.
Osvobojenje in ozdravljenje.
Hallelujah. God wants us to be totally honest.
Bog hoče, da smo popolnoma iskreni.
If we have an issue with anger.
Če imamo slučajno težavo z jezo.
And to hunger for freedom.
In če imamo lakoto po svobodi.
Hallelujah. We have a prayer we're going to say. Can you put that up for us?
Imamo kratko molitev, ki jo bomo zmolili skupaj.
Let's stand up together.
Vstanimo skupaj.
It's coming.
Bo prišla.
Okay. Gospod, prihajam pred tvoj presto, da se oprem duhu jeze in grenkobe. Tvoja beseda pravi, da orožje moje bojevanja
ni meseno, ampak je mogočno za rušenje trnjava. Zato mogočnem imenu Jezusa Kristusa podiram vsako trnjavo jeze, besa in srditosti, ki jo je sovražnik zgradil meni. Gospod, ki sam se za besede in dejanja, ki so odprla vrata jezi in grekobi, ki sam se za pretekle generacijske grehe, ki so odprla vrata duha jezi.
Okay, there's more. Is there more? Okay.
Rekam se vsakršnemu dogovoru z duhom jeze. V Jezusovem imenu preklicujem njegovo nalogo nad svojim življenjem. Mogočnem imenu Gospoda Jezusa Kristusa zapovedujem, naj bo vsak duh jeze zvezan. V meni nima več prostora, ker sem tempelj svetega duha. Moje telo je bilo odkupljeno z dragoceno Jezusovo krvjo, in celoti pripada njemu. Izjavljam, da je vsaka generacijska dediščina jeze, nasilja in nevladanih čustev enkrat za vsele prekinjena iz moje rodbine zaradi Kristusovega dokončanega dela.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Prayer teams, come on up.
Molitvene skupine, vabim vas gor.
And we'd like to pray with you that there will not be a spirit of anger or bitterness in your life.
Radi bi molili z vami, da ne bi bilo več duha jeze in grenkobe v vašem življenju.
So that the Holy Spirit can flow like a river.
Prosto teče skozi vas kot reka.
And any place that anger has ruled.
In kakršenkoli prostor, čemur je vladala jeza v vas.
That peace and joy.
Da pride tam mir in veselje.
The righteous life of the Holy Spirit will now be in the lordship first place
in sinovstvo.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hvala ti, Gospod.